loves us. He makes it very clear. Amen. The Holy Spirit makes it very clear to us that we are the children of love. Amen. That God loves us. We can take that to the bank. No one, no evil can even cancel that which God has for you. Amen. Hallelujah. We have a solid foundation. You will not be moved in the name of Jesus. So Heavenly Father, we just give you our hearts. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Everything that is not like you, even right now, we turn from it and repent in the name of Jesus. We cancel the assignment of the enemy in this hour in the name of Jesus. And we plead the blood of Jesus Christ. Every master spirit is broken down, pulled down right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus is high above all. The name of Jesus is lifted up right now. That name is going to families right now. That name is going to homes right now. That name of Jesus right now is making things all well. Yes, oh God, in people's lives. We thank you. We bless your name. Now I submit myself to you, Lord God, not only me and all of you. Have your way, oh God. Use my lips, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Speak that which you desire to speak. Do that which you desire to do. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, be magnified. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to welcome you. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let the love of God fill your heart today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. The healing power of God. May that healing power of God just saturate your heart. And may the liquid love of God be your portion today in the name of Jesus. Just say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes, so be it.
So be it.
So be it. Whatever the Lord has for you today. Amen. Right. So be it.
So be it.
Hallelujah. And we want to welcome all those who are joining us by the way of the internet, whatever they will hear or receive this message. But the Lord Jesus Christ is actually speaking words, amen, of courage, encouragement. It's almost like, you know, the filters are being removed from people's eyes.
Yeah.
And the Spirit of God is one.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
It's one Holy Spirit. And God's motivation is one.
Yes.
From the book of Genesis to Revelation, mm-hmm. is one word. I love you. It's one word that God has been releasing to all humanity. Amen. Mm-hmm. That he loves his creation. That he loves his people.
Yes.
And he does not just love. God does not just love. He is the love.
Yes.
He does not just love. Amen.
Yes.
He is that which he says he is.
Yes.
So he is love. And when we receive him, we literally receive his love. And one thing I know about God Almighty, amen, the one who made us, hallelujah. When he comes in, he comes with everything that he has. Hallelujah. And so when he comes into our hearts, he brings the love of God in our hearts, amen. And all troubles begin to melt away. Struggles begin to melt away, amen. Confusion begins to melt away. So the Lord wants us to focus on this, what he has given us. And he made it very clear, and I heard it, you know, as we were speaking and worshiping the Lord all day long today. We thank God, even as Minister Erica was sharing about purpose.
Yeah.
And I heard it very clearly that God needs people to know that there's a culture of his kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
That there is literally God's kingdom that is in operation.
Yes.
That there are two kingdoms that are operating. But God's kingdom, hallelujah, is above all, and it is an eternal kingdom. Amen. Hallelujah. And his purpose is for us to learn that he loves us. And that none of us is called like another. Each one is important before God. And the why we do what we do, why we prepare ourselves, amen. why we get ourselves ready is so that we can be our best. And we are our best to be able to serve others at the highest level. Hallelujah. So God plants himself in us. So we cannot count ourselves out. Amen. Because that which you have, I need. Amen. The same thing. Now I believe what God is doing in the body of Christ. For a long time, the body of Christ was centered on religion. Centered on this is how we believe. These are our belief systems. But people forgot that we have one Lord. Hallelujah. And because we have one Lord, we have one baptism. Amen. Jesus Christ is coming back for a united body. Hallelujah. And he's coming back for united body. I say this to say that, you know, I heard a man of God, actually it was Kenneth Hagin, who spoke, very anointed man of God. Amen. That has done many things before he went home to go to be with the Lord. But he spoke one of the times he was preaching about the Holy Spirit and just demonstrating. Was actually not speaking, just speaking the words, but he was demonstrating when the Holy Spirit comes, there is joy. And as he was walking among, you know, the congregation, he would just stand by someone just because of the anointing of the Lord.
Yes.
And they would just flip over or just fall over or they would just start to burst out in laughter.
Yes.
And now we know what we have gone through, not only this country, but across the nations.
That's right.
The spirit of grief. Amen.
Yeah.
So how is that going to be dealt with? It's going to be by the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Because the Holy Spirit comes and the Holy Spirit brings the joy of the Lord.
Yes.
But when that man of God was preaching about the Holy Spirit, he was, I mean, he is very gifted and was able to show about faith and speak about faith. And many, we know many prophets of God, you know, learned from him about living by faith. But he made a statement. He said, the Lord told him, others can preach about faith, but I want you to concentrate on the Holy Spirit. The power of the Holy Spirit. I say that to say that God calls ministries for a specific assignment.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And that's why we do not compare. You don't compare your ministry to somebody else's ministry.
That's right.
The Lord Jesus Christ has an assignment. If you are the finger, do everything that the finger is able to do or called to do. If you are the eye, if you are the foot, if you are the arm, amen, hallelujah. And all of a sudden, we're going to be one because the body comes back. The body comes together as one. And before Jesus comes back, hallelujah, it's going to be very clear. Very clear in the body of Christ. He's not called us to be religious. He's not impressed with us sitting and rising up in a traditional manner. But he is impressed with our hearts. He looks at the heart. Amen? The Bible says men look on the outside. We can impress all we want on Sunday morning. But what happens on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday? Hallelujah. What happens at midnight when nobody's watching? Hallelujah. God wants us to come with our hearts.
Yes.
Men look on the outside,
yeah.
But God is looking at the heart.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And everything is in the heart. Hallelujah. Yes. And so he wants us to receive his love,
yeah.
Because the only way we can make it, you know, in this world, but not of this world, the only way we can function in the world with the understanding and the revelation that we are in this world, but not of this world, is only by faith that works by the love of God.
Yes.
And so he wants us to go back and reveal what is it that he has called us to. And, you know, we have to have that mindset, that frame of mindset, how where we are operating from. That we're not operating from a religious mindset. We are actually operating from a kingdom mindset.
Yeah.
Amen. That's why we can develop ourselves. And whatever we find to do, we do it with all our might.
That's true.
You know, even if it's, you're a student in class and you're given homework, you know, you're given homework, you got to do it to the best of your ability. And the thing about it is you don't do it in the best of your ability. You do it by the anointing. That's what makes, you know, God-fearing young people so special, because you can call to a higher supernatural power. You can call on God to help you. Amen.
Yeah.
Because the enemy doesn't want the kids to be their best.
Right.
He doesn't want them to excel. And so all these things show up. Amen. But what God wants us to do is to depend on him.
Yeah.
So that we can do more. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. God wants us to depend on him so we can do more and be used by him. So the reason why God gives us the assignments to do, and I'm back to that school thing. The reason why God even wants the, you know, our young people to excel in school is because there's a calling of God upon their lives.
Yes.
And the Lord is looking for a channel to utilize, amen, to deposit within them supernaturally an understanding that the world cannot receive. And that which God wants to do is going to be by revelation. So we cannot excuse ourselves out, amen. Come on, listen to me. Young people, you cannot excuse yourself out and say, so-and-so is better than me. God made you an individual. You have individual desires. Amen. Some are called to be scientists. Some are called to be artists. Some are called to be in the marketplace. Others are called to be at the pulpit. Amen. Encouraging others so that you can be your best. See, you got to be willing to be your best. Amen. And I believe that's why the enemy attacks children even in the womb. I believe that's why the enemy attacks even children growing up, abuses. Why do you think that happens? It's because the enemy can see the mark of God. And he can see the call of God upon their lives. And if he can just cause all this whirlwind to show up, he hopes that people are not going to fulfill what God intended them to fulfill. But the devil is too late in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because love of God heals all wounds. The love of God heals all wounds. Amen. And so we got to know that we are not being religious. Please. Because Jesus Christ did not bring religion to the world. He brought a kingdom, a way of life. Amen. He brought a way of life. He brought an understanding that we have authority. You can say no. Hallelujah. You know, as you grow and as you go into leadership, you can't take every assignment. You know, every assignment shows up. Some are distractions. You got to say no. Amen. You got to say no and be very specific at what you say yes to. Make sure that you hear that this is God leading you to do that. Amen. Hallelujah. And so in life, God is going to show us many things, but we got to choose what he has for us. So in God's kingdom, he has a way of doing things. There is a culture. Jesus did not bring a religious mindset. He brought actually kingdom upon his shoulder. Isaiah says that the government shall be upon his shoulder. And because a government has a king, Jesus Christ is a king. Hallelujah. God, literally, the Father has turned all things to Christ. And the Bible says they are now turned all things to Christ for the church. All the church has something to do. Amen. Hallelujah. So let's come back and take a look at these scriptures about the love of God. Exploring about kingdom culture, which is love and serving. And that's why I was smiling and just, rejoicing as Minister Erica was speaking about service. Amen. Because it all ties together. The Lord gave this to me in my heart that we are to release the kingdom of culture. The kingdom of God culture is about love and serving.
Yeah.
It's about love and serving. We serve God and we serve others.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And the service is not because people deserve anything. Actually, when God sends you out to serve, it's not going to be because people deserve it. Hallelujah. It's going to be to serve to people who cannot even say thank you to you. You serve by assignment. Amen. So let's go back to the commandment that the Lord Jesus Christ gave us. John chapter 13, verse 34. And I say commandment. The kingdom is run by laws. You are in God's kingdom. Amen. And in God's kingdom, there are laws. And the law that he has given us is love. And it's the law that he is himself. So he has given us to live by himself. Amen. To live through him. Everything that we do, that's why you're going to make it. That's why you cannot fail. Amen. That's why there is no shame for you. Because no one can shame God. Hallelujah. And God cannot fail. And God is in you. Hallelujah. So set yourself up for success. Anyone who was preparing not to make it, set yourself up for success. Amen. Hallelujah. You cannot prepare not to make it. You prepare to move forward because God is with you.
Amen.
He's holding you up. The one who is in you is greater than he who is in the world.
Amen.
John 13, verse 34 says, a new commandment I give to you. A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another as I have what? Loved you. As an example. Jesus says, I've loved you, that you also love one another.
Yes.
He says, there's a new commandment. There's a shifting. A new administration has taken place, has taken rulership. It's a new way of doing things. Amen. Hallelujah. And so when you are transferred from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light, you come under a new administration.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Where Jesus Christ is the head. Where love prevails, amen, where everything is provided for, and your assignment now changed from seeking things, hallelujah, to seeking the King. Because when we seek the King, then we have the things. When we seek the King, that's what the Bible says there very clearly. Seek ye first, what? The kingdom of God. Yes, and his righteousness. And then all these things are being added. And we know God's addition is not similar to humans' way of adding. God adds and multiplies exponentially. Hallelujah. He does which no man can do. And so the Bible is telling us that we have a new way of thinking, a new way of living, a new commandment that says we are to love just the way Jesus Christ loved us. So how did he love us? He loved us when we were all messed up. Come on. Jesus did not wait for us to get it all together. That's a tactic of the enemy. When the enemy places upon our people's lives to wait until things get better so we can serve God. God wants you to serve through the process. Amen. Serve him through the wilderness. Your calling is not the wilderness. I heard somebody who said, I have been in the wilderness for, I think they said 56 years, so they must have been older. That is not God's intention. That's not God's will. Listen, even for the children of Israel, it was not God's intention for them to be in the wilderness for 40 years. No, 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 no. God loves you so much, but even in the wilderness, they were provided for. God wants you to know that your calling is not the wilderness. Hallelujah. You are going through the wilderness, but it shall come to pass. God of love is carrying you through. Don't settle in the wilderness. Amen. You are to come over. The assignment of God is for you to occupy God's kingdom. God is thinking greater things, greater than your neighborhood. Amen. God has nations for you. Nations to be influenced by your presence. Nations to receive a mark that you existed in this planet Earth. Amen. That you are sent forth by God. And that you existed. Hallelujah. And you came to do God's will. So that's why Jesus says, no, things have changed. Somebody say things have changed.
Things have changed.
A kingdom has come. Jesus is saying there's a new way of doing things. It's not going to be the world way of doing things. Hallelujah. You're going to be different. You're going to act the way that I act. You're going to imitate me. Verse 35 says that by this. So you are an example. The Bible says by this all will know. By this all will know that you are what? My possessive. You are mine. You are my disciples. Disciples means that you are able to be taught. You are willing to be taught, to learn new ways. And when you learn new ways, you act differently. Can I behave the same way as the children of Israel behaving as if they are in Egypt? Amen. When the Lord moves us from the kingdom of the world, we become members of God's kingdom. Hallelujah. And because we are members of God's kingdom, we are ready to be taught. Because we've never been this way before. Yes. You've never been here before. Hallelujah. So that's why the Holy Spirit comes to teach us. And the first teaching is a coming. It's a teaching that you are loved. You belong to God. You are accepted. Amen. Hallelujah. You are in the family. Come on. You are God's family. And he's constantly teaching us in our hearts that you are a children of God. What does that mean? I'm a child of who? Of God. Who is God? He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords, the creator of heaven and earth, the one who owns all things, and that you are a child of God. That means that you are in God's family. Hallelujah. You are not a servant as an outsider. You serve because you're a child. Hallelujah. You serve. You know, in the family, they say, you know, come on, Johnny, take the garbage out. Come on, Johnny, do this. They're not servants. They're serving because they are children in the family. They are in the estate. They own the estate with their father. Amen. And because we own something, we serve willingly. We serve from the heart. Hallelujah. Yeah. The Lord wants us to know that as his children, that he's has given us a new way of life. A new commandment I've given you. And this is what he's saying. The world. Come on. By this all will know. Who is all? The world. will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another. The Bible is saying that you've been promoted. There is a promotion. The love of God promotes us. You know, the enemy always looks for the things that we are not. But God is telling us the things that we are. We belong to him. Hallelujah. He is telling us that I love you unconditionally. It's, and in this love that you can be taught, amen, to be able to serve others. Now take a look at John 17. As we go developing ourselves in this kingdom culture. Kingdom culture, amen. The kingdom of heaven culture. The way of doing things, hallelujah. The way of doing things, which is by love, God's love. God's love that heals all, amen. Because in the world, we will have tribulations, but the Bible says you need to be of good cheer. You got to be of good cheer. Why? Because this love has overcome all for us. You have to be able to find some cheer right in the middle of when the enemy thinks that you're going to give up and that you have no help and the enemy is whispering to your ears that nobody loves you. But the Holy Spirit is saying, no, but you are loved by God. And if only you are the only person present in the earth, God, Christ would have come for you. Yeah. Amen. Even if you are the only one, Christ would come. Yeah. John 17, take a look at this. This is what how much the Lord loves us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. John 17, verse 20 says, my prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me. Yeah. Hallelujah. In their word. Next verse. Jesus prayed for you. You can settle yourself there. That the Lord Jesus Christ prayed for us to make it. Yes. And he prayed for us to know his love. Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah. To know his love. That they all may be one. Yes. As you, Father, are in me. Now listen, Jesus is praying to the Father. And he's remembering us in that prayer. And I in you, that they also may be one in us. Right? That the world may believe that you sent me. Yes. Because love always gives itself. Hallelujah. When the love of God is working in us, the Lord's going to send you into places whereby only he can do. Yes. And he's going to open doors only he can open. Hallelujah. Yes. And you're going to step into those doors by faith. Yes. Thank you, Lord God. And you're not going to do things because of force. You're going to do things by anointing. Hallelujah. I've said, Lord God, help me. I'm not going to mark these papers when I don't feel like marking them, right? Hallelujah. I'm not going to read this article when I don't feel like reading it, amen. I'm not going to do this work when I don't feel like doing it. I'm going to pray for grace. I am going to pray for passion. I'm going to pray for the anointing, amen. So remember that whatever you're called to do, whatever you're doing, an assignment is, ask for God to give you the anointing to do it. Ask the Holy Spirit to help you, because whatever you find your hand to do, you need to do it with all your might, because God is with you. Yes. And it's a constant self-reminding that the Lord is the one who is sending you to do that work. Amen. And he will back you up. And so that's why this love works, because the Lord sends us by love. Everything that he sends us to do is because we can demonstrate his love, because the world needs to see unconditional love. The world needs to see that God is working in you. Next verse. Hallelujah. Verse 22 says, and the glory which you gave me, Jesus did not hold back. He says, the glory that you gave me, I have given them, that they may be one just as we are one. Now, if you stop right there and think, and we're going to come back to here, but if you stop right there and think about, there's a scripture about the prodigal son that is in the book of Luke, Luke chapter 15, I believe. In the prodigal son, the Bible says this son went, asked for his inheritance, and the father gave the inheritance of that to the prodigal son. And because the father gave the inheritance, he took everything and went and wasted it. And then finally came to his senses and came back home. But as he was coming back home, the father saw him from very far. And he saw him from so far, and he was waiting for him to come back home. And the Bible says very clearly when this prodigal son, who was saying, just don't make me a son, but make me a servant, please. You know, at least even the servants in the house of my father have something to eat. So he was looking for provision, but God wanted him to come. The father wanted him to come back because everything the father has is his. And so when the father saw that young man coming, you know what he did? He said, bring the best robe. So Jesus said, I'm giving you the same glory. That prodigal son in the book of Luke chapter 15, the father didn't say, where have you been? You smell like pigs. What have you been eating? There's something wrong with you. Now bring the fire hose, whatever, and water. Let's wash him. Don't even wash him in my bathroom. Take him to the outhouse over there and let him wash over there first. Yeah. No, he took him just the way he was. Yeah. Uh-huh. And clothed him. Yeah, right. Put a robe on him. Yes, the best robe. The best, right. And not only that, he took a ring out. And put that ring on the finger of that young man, saying that you belong to me, irrespective of how you feel. So when we look back here, we can see what Jesus did. Jesus says the same glory, the same garment, the same righteousness that you gave me, I'm giving them. And with this glory, they can now come in love into the presence of the Father. Look, Daddy, he says, Father, I'm bringing them all in. You gave them to me. I'm bringing them all in by love. Amen. Yes. And he did not bring them naked. Yes. He clothed them with himself. Yes, he has clothed us with himself. Yes. Hallelujah. And let's go to the next verse. Verse 23. I in them. It's a perfect unity. Yeah. That which God does is progressive. Hallelujah. God is progressive. He is bringing us closer and closer and closer to himself. And no one can see God's glory and remain the same.
That's right. Yeah.
Moses says, show me your glory.
Yeah.
And did God show Moses his glory?
Yeah.
He showed him his glory. And the Bible says he showed him his hinder part. And by seeing God's glory, Moses' understanding opened. And he was able to see all God's purposes all the way to the beginning of Genesis. And that's how Moses was able to receive revelation and tell us God's intentions from the beginning. Hallelujah. And so Jesus was not holding back. He says, I in them. You in me, perfect unity,
yes.
Humanity united with their God.
Yes.
There has never been such a case. And that's why the Bible says when we come to Jesus Christ, we are made new.
Yes.
We are a new creation that can function only in love. Amen. Hallelujah. I in them, you in me, so that they may be what? Brought to complete unity. Is that up there? Made perfect in one.
Yes.
And that the world, come on. Jesus is always looking of how the world can come in.
Right. Yeah.
He's saying so that they can be made perfect like this, so that, Father, we can fulfill your purpose.
Yeah.
Your purpose of sending me. Because you love the world so much. See, listen, it's not just about you. The enemy wants us to focus on me and myself and I. But God says, no, no, no. The world is bigger than you. The call is greater than you. Hallelujah. And only God wants to do it and reach the world through us. There's a world that you ought to reach. There's a world that you need to reach. Amen. There's a world that this young person can reach. Amen. Hallelujah. There's a message that he's given us. And the message is reconciliation.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. To reconcile not just some people.
No.
But at the end of the day, God's plan is that all may come to the full knowledge of Christ. Because God is looking to eternity. He's looking to his kingdom that shall never end. Hallelujah. And so that's why he is saying here that we have been made perfect in him, right?
Yeah.
And that the world may know that you have sent me. So walking in this God's love, unconditional love, is a witness to the world.
Mm-hmm.
It's a witness to the world. And the way the world is going to come is when we get it together in the body of Christ.
Yes, right. Yes. Yes.
When we get it together in the body of Christ. Amen. Yes. There ought to not be in the body of Christ whereby a sister or a sister there cannot even say hello to that sister. The devil is a lie. Hallelujah. That is not God's body. That's not God's church. Hallelujah. I don't care what they have done. Jesus told Peter, even if your brother, you know, sins and they come back to you seven times, whatever, just continue to forgive them.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. So he says, until the world knows that you have sent me and have loved them as you have loved me. Now, that's high.
Yes.
Amen. Mm-hmm. That actually, Jesus wants us to know that the Father loves you the same way he loves his Son,
that's
Jesus
right.
Christ.
That's right.
And you gotta receive that. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Despite all the hurts and all the pains,
right.
God says that the same way the Father loves Jesus is the same way the Father loves you. Hallelujah. So then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them.
Yes.
You have loved them the same way.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
How did the Father love Jesus? With every fiber of his being.
Yes.
But yet what happened to Jesus? He went to the cross. Amen.
Yes.
He actually went to the cross and suffered through the cross.
Yes.
But there was promotion. There's always promotion. Amen. There's a promotion with the Father. When we serve the Father in love, there's a promotion. But listen to me. This love I'm talking about is a fruit of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
It is only by the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
It's the Holy Spirit that places this kind of love in our hearts.
Yes.
We cannot do it on our own. You can only go so far in your own ability.
Yes.
But God wants us to go far. Amen. Because he's called you into the kingdom. He's called you to operate with a kingdom culture of love. Hallelujah. And he wants us to go far. He says that Jesus Christ is the vine. Come on, who are you connected to? I'm here to remind us that we are connected to the vine. Jesus Christ is the vine. Amen. And because he's the vine, you are a branch. We cannot act as if we are the vine. No, Jesus says very clearly he's the vine. And we are the branch. And the purpose of the branch is to birth the fruit.
Right.
The flowers bud from the branches, not on the vine, but they are sustained by the vine.
Yeah.
And listen, when you see the vine, there are roots too. Hallelujah. So we are anchored deep down in love. We are rooted and grounded in love. And that is why you will not be shaken. You got to make sure that your rooting and grounding is in love. And it starts off by saying this back to the Father. I truly know that the Father really loves us to tell him and to acknowledge that he loves us.
That's right.
You know, instead of coming and saying, look at how much I'm suffering.
Right.
Look at how much what is going on. All the that's called murmuring. And that's called complaining. But if we come to the Father and say, Father, I may not understand it all.
Yeah.
But I know that you love me.
Yes.
And I thank you for your love.
Yes.
I thank you that you have divine appointment over my life. I might not know how it's going to happen. But you know the details.
Yes.
And I thank you for the details too.
Yes.
And I thank you for the process too.
Yes.
I know you're working through something in
yes,
me. But I know that because you're working it out, it's going to be all right
yes.
because I see where Jesus is.
Yes.
And because
yes.
I see where Jesus is, he turned out all right.
Yes.
Although he suffered
yes.
and
yes.
although he became poor,
yes.
I know now see where he is. And you love me the same way you love him. So
yes.
I can tell you, Father, thank you.
Yes, thank
he's
you.
Working it out.
Yes.
Somebody needs to know today that the Lord, that your heavenly Father is working it out. He's working out the details. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah. No every lying spirit is cast out in the name of Jesus. It will not stand. The shaming spirit of darkness and guilt and condemnation has no place in your life. He is too late in the name of Jesus. It is very clear. According to the scripture, that the Lord loves you.
Yes. Yes.
And it's not anyone. It's the Father.
Yes.
The Father.
The Father.
The Father loves you. Think about that. It's the Father who said, let us
yes.
make man in our own image.
Yes.
is the Father who said, Son, let's do this. Holy Spirit, let's do this. And he did not hold anything back. And he breathed on this dirt. It's the Father who knows that he made you in dirt. He knows that you are but dirt, but he took himself and put his breath in this dirt. He took and he put himself in that dirt. He knows exactly how he made you. So is this Father. On that day when Satan came with his deceptions and spoke words to Eve, and Eve joined herself and Adam together with the enemy, is the Father that hurt so much. He hurt so much to be separated from his man, his family that he made. And he wanted his family to rule on this earth, to take instructions from heaven and then run those instructions in this earth so that it is on earth as it is in heaven. But blessed be the name of the Lord. The Father was not willing, amen, to let you go. That's why the Bible says very clearly, he loved the world so much. So he gave everything. He said, I'm a God of faith. I'm going to give everything that I have. What do I have? And Jesus said, I'm going. Because it's the words that the words brought sin in the world. It's words. So he said, I'm the word. I'm going. And I'm going to die. The word became flesh and dwelt among us. Amen. And the purpose of it all is so that the word can sacrifice himself. I'm going somewhere with this. Somebody, I am right now uncovering in the name of Jesus. I'm bringing light to that situation that the enemy has used for a long time to lie. There will be no lies in the name of Jesus. There will be no darkness in the name of Jesus. There will be light. The Bible says, let there be light. Let there be light. Hallelujah. Let there be light. And Jesus came as a humble servant. And he knew his purpose. His purpose was to bring this kingdom we're talking about on this planet Earth. Amen. And he said, I must go to that village and that village to preach the kingdom of God, because that is why I came. He knew that he was a king, and he went everywhere preaching, but he was not preaching religion. He was preaching, amen, kingdom. He was preaching that we are citizens. You can be born in the kingdom. And he said many times that your Father in heaven, amen. He said many times about the Father. That's why he came, but he did not hold himself back. He gave himself to the death, even the death of the cross. And listen, the Bible says, let me go to Second Corinthians chapter 5. Listen, hallelujah. The love is working. The love of God is working. This love is healing wounds. And some wounds are really deep. Some wounds are generational wounds.
Yes, they are.
In the name of Jesus. But that love is able to go deep down. Think about the vine and the root. Amen. We are rooted and grounded in his love. So that love of God is going down to the roots in the name of Jesus. And generations are being cleared. Even not only this generation, but generations to come in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Are spoken for by the blood, by the love of God. Amen. The enemy will find no place this time to take a hold of generations, because the healing power of God that comes by the love of God has taken effect in your family. Amen. Second Corinthians chapter 5. Take a look, because the love of God changed our assignment. The Bible says a new commandment I've given you. But now once we have come to Christ, there is a new assignment. Hallelujah. For the sake of time, but I'm going to just read on. So let's start with 17. Amen. Verse 17. Again, make it very clear. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And the devil is a lie. And I saw how the enemy has been using this pandemic and these lockdowns, you know, to cause people to go into shells. But there is no place the love cannot go.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. For people to lose purpose and lose focus.
Yeah. Yeah.
But when we come to Christ, hallelujah, we find that our God is never late. And he knows everything that is going on. Hallelujah. And because he knows everything that is going on, we're going to seek the Lord. Amen. We are hungry according to the word of the Lord. Amen. The Bible says if we are thirsty, we shall be filled. And so what has happened is that there's a hunger and a thirst for God. There's a hunger and a thirst to know this God. God, do you still love me? Yes, he said, yes, I love you the same way I love my son. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so because of that, there's a transformation that is taking place.
Yes, Lord.
And because of that, amen, people are no longer moving as, like a crowd.
Mm-hmm.
People are now began to see God for themselves. You got to see God for your family. See God for yourself. Unite back to him.
Yes.
Now, listen, when we received Jesus Christ, things changed.
Yes.
And it says, therefore, if anyone... If anyone,
anyone.
Hallelujah. Mm. Those in the mainstream and those in the who used to be in the margins.
Yeah.
It's everyone.
Everyone.
The rich, the poor,
yes.
All, everyone, all races,
yes.
All. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation.
Thank the Lord.
Listen, when God says a new creation, he means a new creation. So there is a being that is operating right now. You, when you come to Christ, that has never existed before.
Yes.
You are a new creation, a new race. Amen. And old things, what? Have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Next verse. All things. Jesus Christ makes a playing field that we are starting fresh.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
The enemy is never in control. In fact, that which he has, he stole from Adam. Now Jesus said, I'm taking it. And nobody is going to be able to take it from my hand.
Yeah.
Everything has been turned over to Jesus Christ for the church.
Yes. Yes.
For the church.
Yes.
For those who believe in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord.
In him. Now all things are what? What did you say? All things are what? All things are of God. All things belong to you. Somebody needs to get their car.
Yeah, thank you, Lord. Yeah, thank you, Lord.
Somebody needs to get back their family.
Yes, yes.
You got to get a hold of it. You got the authority and the power.
Yes.
I said, Lord, I'm not leaving anything at the table. I want everything that belongs to me and my family, not only for this generation, but generations to come. You got to stand your ground. Hallelujah. You have air that you're breathing. Amen. That air is free. The same thing, everything that Jesus Christ has for you is for you. Amen. There is no competition here.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because you are birthed out from him. There is abundance for you. There is an abundance for God's people.
Thank you, Lord.
All things are of God.
Yeah.
Now listen, the devil has nothing. That's why he goes around saying limited resources.
Yeah.
Because it's true. You know, in this kingdom, things are limited.
Yeah.
But when we find our purpose in Christ Jesus and we are walking in love, now get ready for the outbursts of what God is about to release upon the church of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
the things that he has you to do is not only to touch your 1, 2, and 3, but to touch nations, amen, to be able to lend to many nations and not borrow. Hallelujah. So he is saying that who what has God done? Who has reconciled us where? To himself. When that prodigal son came back home, he did not say, well, let me see, how much can I borrow? How much can I have? He said, he stepped in. And the father said, bring the fatted calf.
Yes, he did.
Bring that calf that we had kept for such a moment as this. Kill it. Let's do what? Let's party. When a child, when a new believer comes to the kingdom of God, listen, there is a party in heaven. There is a celebration in heaven. Do you think the heaven celebrates and then God puts you in trouble? Hallelujah. No, God has reconciled us back to own the things that he has for us. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And the Bible says it's through Jesus Christ and has given us what? The ministry. So we have the ministry of telling others. Of ministry, of telling others. You don't want to waste your time being out here. There's this now kingdom of God. Now, kingdom of God, kingdom of heaven is in operation.
Yeah.
And it's operating by the laws of love. Come on in. God loves you. The same way God, the Father loves, Jesus Christ also loves you. Come on in. There is more abundant life for you. Amen. He is giving you the ministry. It's a ministry. It's a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle of going everywhere you go. You're reconciling people as you sit down in that office or in your Zoom room. As you are working, you are there for reconciliation. Amen. As you are in that classroom, hallelujah, you have the ability to reconcile others in, back to God. By even your thoughts, when you think good thoughts about people, when you wish them well, hallelujah, when you are praying under your breath in your heart, asking the Lord, let your will be done in this place. Hey, hallelujah. You're occupying the place of Jesus Christ who lives in the inside of you.
Yes.
Next verse, hallelujah. So the ministry of reconciliation has been given to us. Why? Because the Father is still waiting.
Yes.
Has seen you from far. And he's been waiting. He has seen us from far and has been waiting for us to come home.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That is that God was what? Now listen, that is deep. Because the Bible is saying God was in Christ reconciling the whole world to himself. So how did Jesus reconcile the world to God? By dying on the cross. And when I think about this, the Bible is telling me that God literally died for us. God the Father literally died through Jesus and brought him out from death. It says that God was, so he suffered. Your Father suffered for you. And so what the enemy would say is a lie. The enemy saying that he does not, God doesn't love you is a lie. It's a demonic lie. Because God was in Christ. He didn't send Jesus out. Go, you go do it. No. The Bible is saying that God the Father was in Christ and went through the pain and turmoil of the cross with his son for us, to love us, to bring us higher with him. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, not imputing. God was not looking what you did wrong. He was not trying to put the wrong on you.
That's right.
No, he does not condemn. Let me just make it clear. God does not condemn anyone.
He does not.
No, God does not condemn. He did not condemn us. Hallelujah. But he was not imputing their trespasses to them, right? And was what? And has committed to us the word of reconciliation. He was not saying the things that we did wrong. He was saying what we have right. Amen. He was saying that I'm giving you. You are mine. I'm taking you back. Hallelujah. So it's time to take back that which belongs to us. Hallelujah. The love of God works. The love of God is working. And listen, you are in the kingdom of God. And listen, we know the end. We know how the end works. Does. Let's read verse 20 real quick. Hallelujah. We've got victory. Verse 20 says, now then, we are what? Promotion time. Promotion time. Hallelujah. You're not just for your own neighborhood only. You're an ambassador now. You represent God's kingdom. You are the ambassador of Christ. As though God were what? Pleading through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, what?
Be reconciled
to God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And what is that? What is the purpose of all this love and all this reconciliation? Hallelujah. It's so that we can fulfill God's will and God's love for us. Listen, you win with God.
Yes.
I'm going to read one scripture and I'm gonna be done with this, finalized with this scripture here. Take a look at Daniel. Chapter 7, verse 18. The love of God takes care of all the hurts and all the pains. Because it's very clear, hallelujah, that God has been patient with us. He is love. He's been very patient. He's been very kind.
Yes, 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 yes.
He's been very kind to us.
Yes, he has.
He's not just sought his own. He sought us out.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And he trusts us. He has so much faith in you. Hallelujah. He has so much faith in you. And he delights in us. Amen. He delights in us. And not only that, he protects us. He will protect. He will send his warring angels on your behalf. Don't you ever think that you are alone. Hallelujah. He will send warring angels. Come on. Trust the Lord. Ask for warring angels to go working for us as you rise, as you walk. There are places that when you're walking, they feel dangerous. Call on the angels of God to help you. Amen. Because the Bible says he will give his angels charge over you. He will give his angels charge over you. Hallelujah. That's his assignment. You got to ask because you're a child. You are a child in God's kingdom. So let me read this final one to show you where we are headed. Daniel chapter 7, verse 18. Verse 18.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Verse 18 says this, but the saints, somebody say that's me.
That's me.
The saints, amen, the set apart ones.
Yes.
Those who have been reconciled back to God.
Yes.
Those who have received Christ. Mm-hmm. But the saints of the who?
Most
of the Most High God. Right?
Yeah.
Shall what?
Take the kingdom. Yeah.
The saints of the Most High God shall take the kingdom.
Yeah.
And what will they do? They will possess the kingdom. When? Just for one moment? No. Forever and ever. Even forever and ever. Forever and ever and ever. That's God's assignment for you. That's what love does. Hallelujah. That the saints will take the kingdom. God's idea and God's plan is for you to take the kingdom. Hallelujah. It's for you to occupy.
Yes.
And so that the world may see, what? You mean that this person whom I thought could not even do anything, they're doing all this? No. The Bible is saying that that's how the world's going to come running in.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because now the love of God is being demonstrated in your life.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You're no longer living for yourself. You are living in this kingdom, hallelujah, occupying your place and allowing God to use you. You don't know what your assignment will be tomorrow. You just handle today, hallelujah. Prepare yourself today. Whatever you find to do, do it with all your might. And know that the Lord loves you, hallelujah. You might be facing challenges now, but it doesn't mean that God does not love you. Hallelujah. In this world, you will go through tribulations. But be of good cheer.
Yes, Lord.
Let the cheerfulness of God.
Yes. Fill us, Lord.
Let the joy of the Lord,
yes, Lord,
be your strength.
Yes, Lord.
Let the joy of the Lord break out. Amen.
Yes,
break when
out.
It feels so hard, pray God, Lord, give me your joy.
Yes, Lord.
And how you demonstrate that joy is to praise God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Allow praise to come out of your lips.
Yes.
Because it is a sacrifice.
Yes.
It's a sacrifice of praise. Father, I just praise you. In this moment when it looks so difficult, I'm just going to praise you. I'm just going to thank you. Thank you for your love. Come on, just join me wherever you are. Let's thank the Father for his love. How he loved us. We could have been destroyed long time ago in our sin. But he did not allow that. Hallelujah. He allowed us to come to this moment. Many of you have gone through different paths of life, but the Father has not lost. He's not taken his eyes out of you. That's why you are still here. His hand is upon you, and you will touch nations. Hallelujah. You will touch nations. You will touch many people in the name of Jesus, and you will fulfill your purpose. Hallelujah. You will fulfill your purpose, and the length of days he will satisfy for you. In the name of Jesus, the length of days. I come against the spirit of suicide. I come against the spirit of suicide. You spirit of suicide, you are broken. In Jesus' name. You lying demon of oppression. We command you right now. Loose your grip. In the name of Jesus. Loose your grip right now. Let the joy of the Lord be our strength. We are releasing this spirit right now. The spirit of love in the airways. The spirit of love, supernatural love of God, liquid love of God is flowing right now in the name of Jesus. The love of God. The love of God is causing people to arise from their trouble in the name of Jesus. Your situation, somebody, the Lord says somebody's situation is changing. Your situation is changing. That you just receive it right now by faith. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. And just say that word, my situation is changing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. We bring that one back even right now in the name of Jesus. We loose the ministering angels of God to begin to minister even right now in the name of Jesus. Minister right now. Minister of strength. Somebody needs strength. Yes, oh God. We release the spirit of strength. Strength even to stand and having done everything to stand in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. Thank you for your love. Heavenly Father, we thank you for loving us. Thank you, Lord God, for your healing, healing us right now. Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for many of us, leading us into the place of saying, I forgive. I drop that case. Come on, drop it right now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. We're going to pray for those who need to receive Jesus Christ as their personal Savior at this particular time. Just pray this prayer if you've not made Jesus to be your Lord and your Savior. This is the time to come into the kingdom. In the name of Jesus. Just pray this prayer with me. Dear Lord, I come to you. Thank you, Lord God, because you say in your word, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I'm calling upon your name right now. Dear Lord, I believe that you died for me, that you resurrected the third day. I ask you to come to my life. I repent of all my sins. From this day forth, I take you to be the Lord over my life. I repent of everything that is unlike you. I command Satan to lose his hold over my life. Fill me up with your Holy Spirit from this day forth. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. If you prayed that prayer for the very first time, you're a child of God. Welcome to the family of God. Hallelujah. Make sure that you join yourself to a Bible-believing church. Allow the Lord to begin to build you up from this moment on in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We want to encourage those who are online to go ahead and give. Hallelujah. This message, the kingdom of God, is being preached on every nation. Hallelujah. And the Lord is going to bless you. We're also going to worship the Lord our God with our communion. We're going to take communion together. And I do want to encourage our families, whatever you are, you can take communion right at home. Hallelujah. And you can just have fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ right at your own household. And God's going to bless you. Amen. God bless you. We're going to go ahead and take our communion real quick. And if you're here and you actually need special prayer, after we do the communion, we can just release a special prayer on you. Hallelujah. You can stand when you get that cup together. Let's do it. Stand in honor of the Lord our God. I know God is doing something new. He's doing something marvelous with your life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. On the night that Jesus Christ was betrayed, he actually took the bread and he blessed it. And he gave it to the disciples saying, take, eat, this is my body that is given for you. And he also took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them saying, drink it all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is being poured out for many for the remission of sins. And I say that I shall not drink again this fruit of the vine until you drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. Father, we thank you for the broken body of Jesus Christ. As we take it by faith. And we thank you for the cup that has been poured out for us in Jesus' name. We can take it all together as one. Take the body of Christ. Amen. There is deliverance. There is healing that is going forth even as you take that in the name of Jesus. Take your cup. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord. Come on, just somebody praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. Thank Him, thank Him, thank Him, thank Him. Thank Him, thank Him for deliverance. Thank Him for the healing power. Thank Him for today. Thank you for this new day. Thank you for this new day. In the name of Jesus. Amen.